Hi guys, welcome back to the course. And from this video we will start making the application dynamic. So first of all, we will start from the header navigation. So we will pull these categories from the database. To do that, we have to create a categories table inside our blog CMS database. So let's go to phpMyAdmin, select the blog CMS database, and let's create a table called categories, and it will have two columns. After that, click the go button, and now name the columns. The first one will be ID, the second one will be text, and the ID will be integer and it will be maximum 11 characters, and it will also be primary key and auto increment. So check this and go, and the text will be varchar and it will be maximum 100 characters. So now click this save button to create the table. Now you can see the table has been created. So let's add some categories inside the table so that we had something to work with. So let's add some categories. The first one will be Java, second one will be PHP. Click this go button, and now you can see it turned green. That means that the rows has been inserted. So browse, and now you can see Java and PHP, two rows has been inserted, ID 1 and 2. So now we can pull these categories and display here in the menu. So as you may remember that this header navigation is inside the header.php file. So let's open header.php file in Notepad++. So here you can see this is the nav bar. So you can see here we have hard coded the categories here, but now we will pull them from the database. So to do that, we have to execute a database query, and we will use our database connection to execute the query. And you may remember that we had created a connection inside this db.php file, so we will not have to create it again. We will just be using it. So first of all, let's create a query. Query equals to select all from categories. I am simply saying select all rows from the categories table. And now we want to execute this query on the database object. And as you may remember, the name of the database object was DB. And we have to call the query function of this DB object to execute this query. So let's copy this variable query. We can also directly pass the query inside this function, but that is also a way to do it. So this query will actually return MySQLi underscore result object, and that object will contain all the rows of the categories table. So let's create a variable, and we are simply saying execute this query and store all the rows returned by the query inside this categories variable. Now when we have the categories, we can now start working here. So now we don't want these three. So above this, let's create a PHP block, and first of all we will check if there are some rows in the database. So to do that, we have to use the categories variable we created above, categories, this method is very simple. We are simply saying if categories, if rows inside the categories variable or rows which are returned from the database are greater than 0, then what we want to do, then we will execute a while loop which will loop through all the rows. And let's first close this if, and now let's create a while loop, and this loop will actually loop through all the categories. And let's close this while loop here. Now inside this while loop we will create a variable, and categories, now we are simply saying, we are simply calling the fetch source method of this MySQL result object, and this method returns the next row inside the result set object. So MySQL underscore result is also called a result set, by the way. So we will store that row inside this row variable, and now we have the row, so we can output the data to the screen. So now let's replace this PHP by now, as you may know that we, to output data, we use echo in PHP. So what we want to echo, row, and inside row we want to echo the text. Now if we save it, and if we go to the browser and refresh it, now you can see Java and PHP. There are only two categories in the database, as you remember. So that's why it is showing just two here. So now actually this link is going nowhere, so let's fix this. Oops. Let me do it first and then I will tell you what I am doing. Categories is equal to, oops, echo. What we want to echo now, we want to echo the ID of the row, and I will tell you why we are doing that. Now when we click this Java link, you can see it is saying categories equals to 1. So let me show you in the database. You can see that the category ID of Java is 1. So we will actually pull this category ID from the URL, and based on this ID we will display the posts. So it makes sense. So right now you can see that when I click this, this active class is not moving along with this. So when we click this, we want this to be activated. So we will do that in the next video. So see you then.